very similar first question that I asked Carolyn. You guys going into the conference tournament for the second year in a row, how's the mindset maybe different coming into this one compared to last year?
Yeah, I think that last year us kind of getting there was sort of a milestone in its own, and it sort of invited us to make that our standard in years going forward. So I think this year, especially with, like you guys mentioned, Stony Brook being out a little bit, it kind of was an invitation for everybody to raise their game, including us, and I think that we've been doing just that. And I think you can see that in all of our play, and sort of going into this week, our mentality is just go hard and let's win this championship all together. Obviously, we're focused on Thursday first, Saturday next, but, you know, I think everybody has, you know, that championship in the back of their head.
You guys are going up against a team that you literally just saw on Saturday, and they got you here. What were some of the things that Binghamton was able to take advantage of over on Virtue on Saturday that you guys had to be ready for?
Truthfully, I think that they scouted our offense pretty well. I think they got us back on our heels a little bit, and I think, you know, it caused us to make some mistakes, and, you know, they capitalized on a lot of things that, you know, maybe we didn't do so well, but I think also seeing them again on Thursday is a way for us to clean up those mistakes and really show them who we are. I don't think that Saturday was our best demonstration of who we are as a team and who we have been all season, so I'm really grateful to be able to see them again on Thursday and hopefully make it to that Saturday game.
What are some of the pluses and minuses in playing a team so close together from the last time you played them?
I mean, it just allows us to build off of who we just saw. I think, you know, in the same way that every season you want to build off and improve every year, same with this game. I think that, you know, positive would be just that, again, we get to sort of clean up those mistakes and avenge that loss, but maybe a little bit of a negative is that they get to do the same for us. But in that same way, I'm just really excited to see them again, and I don't really like how they left Burlington, so hopefully we'll see them in Albany and give them a different message.
You guys going into a situation where obviously first things first, you got to win on Thursday, but if you do win on Thursday, you're looking at another game 2 days later. Does that change your approach at all, knowing that if you do accomplish what you want to do on Thursday, that there's a really quick turnaround, or do you not really worry about that and just kind of throw everything into the first game?
I don't think so. I think also with just the conference in general, everyone's kind of just been clawing at each other. It's really sort of even the playing field a lot. And I don't think anybody is going into the semifinal game, you know, sort of on their heels. I think everybody is here to win, and I think it will make for a really exciting weekend. So I think we're going with everything that we got on Thursday, and come Saturday, we know how to take care of our bodies. We are confident in our team. And if we do make it to Saturday, which I hope that we do, we're going to go all in with that game as well.
Do you feel like there's a level of confidence just in terms of, I don't know, having the experience in playing in the conference tournament, but also kind of knowing that this is a completely different situation last year where you're not looking at the potential of a top five team at the end of the road if you do get to the championship game?
Yeah, I mean, I think, again, it just sort of asked everybody to raise their game and be like, this is actually our championship to win. This is our ticket into further play, even beyond America East Conference Tournament. I mean, all respect to Stony Brook, they are an absolute powerhouse in college lacrosse in general, but I think it definitely helps with our confidence a little bit to not see a top five team, you know, twice or three times in the season, depending on, you know, the situation. So I think it definitely just made it sort of an even playing field across the conference, and I think it also allowed us to, like, sort of relax almost and just like let us play our game and really be the team that we can be without having to sort of be in the shadow that Stony Brook has cast along this conference. Again, all respect to them, but I think it just allowed us to sort of demonstrate who we are and sort of show everybody that we are just as good a team to win this conference as anybody else.
Correct me if I'm wrong here. Was this your extra year, or do you have the extra year?
Yeah, this is my last one.
So just knowing for you that however long this goes, there's nothing beyond it.
Yeah.
What's kind of that doing to you from a mental standpoint, or is that something you've even thought about?
Honestly, I think for the most part, I've tried not to think about it. But also, I think it's just sort of underneath all the excitement and everything, it's just kind of almost pushed me to go even harder. I'd love to stay for longer, but, you know, time has come to an end. So I think it just kind of has pushed me to go harder and really want this for my team, but also for myself. I think I've pride myself on being a team leader and being just everything for the team, but I think also for myself, I really want to win this. And I think that every single person that's next to me and on the field or on the sideline also wants that too. And I think we want to prove to everybody that we can also do this. And with it being the last round, it kind of just adds to the pressure and the excitement.
And just like as a leader of this team, you know, what's that mindset that, you know, you want to bring in that locker room, you know, heading into these playoff games?
Sorry, what did you say?
Oh, just like, I guess like being a leader of the team, like what's like the team's mindset, you know, heading into these games, and what's the mindset as a leader, you know, for your team?
Yeah, I mean, I think we just want to make sure that everybody is playing to their highest potential in the sense that, you know, if you make a mistake, that's fine. We just want you to go as hard as you can and make sure that we're all just pushing each other and that we're all kind of in this together. And we want everybody to go out on the field and believe that we can do this. I think in previous years, we've gone up against other teams and, you know, it's sort of been a different sort of mentality. But I think this year we just want to push this idea, like, why not us? There's absolutely no reason, talent-wise or otherwise, why we can't win this tournament just the same as everybody else. Yeah.
Is there a difference between being excited and kind of welcoming? Do you welcome the early rematch or kind of rewrite that last end of the, like, in a winner go home scenario?
Yeah.
Do you welcome that?
Yeah, 100%. Again, I think that we didn't exactly show Binghamton our best game, and I would really like to remind them of who we are.
Good. Thanks, Grace.